Nagenda's death came out this afternoon. Minister in charge of the presidency, Millie Babalanda, confirmed the reports through a tweet on her official handle, where she wrote, "I regret to announce the passing on of senior presidential advisor on media matters, Mzee John Nagenda, who has passed on at Medipal in Kampala. He was unique, principled and knowledgeable. His services will be dearly missed." Nagenda, who was the senior presidential advisor on media and public relations, died at the age of 84 years.
Sunday, John Nagenda, also known as One Man's Week here at Vision Group, gave us a glimpse into his birth, education, life at campus, and politics.
Everywhere I went, they said, Kariamahuri!
Kariamahuri!
Kariamahuri! Now,
more or less an insult.
Yes, they thought they were shaming me, but from here I was very proud.
Very proud.
I'm saying, yes, hello.
Who was Nagenda? John Mwesigwe Robi Nagenda was born on April 25, 1938, in Rwanda. His parents were William Chanjo Nagenda and Sala Maliamo Bakaluba. John Nagenda was the firstborn of the seven children. His parents were missionaries who had gone to Rwanda to spread the gospel in 1938. They returned to Uganda when Nagenda was about 2 or 3 years.
Born in Rwanda.
Yes.
When my parents were there.
As evangelists.
As evangelists.
Yes.
Evangelists. Again. Not evangelist, evangelist. Evangelist.
Evangelist.
Where
mark that.
Kakati, we went through Nairobi. There are so many people there. Some of them are legitimate. The majority.
Nagenda attended Busoga College, Mwiri and King's College Budo for his junior and secondary school education. Nagenda appeared in one first-class cricket match in England in 1975 and played cricket for Uganda. Nagenda, who lived in England for over 10 years before returning to Uganda, has been a writer and newspaper columnist since 1960s. He was regarded as one of the pioneer writers for East Africa. His first book, Emmere ya Baganda, Food for Baganda, was published in 1962 under Oxford Publishers. In an interview with Urban TV on a senior citizen program on the 30th of June 2022, Nagenda confessed his intense hatred for the former president of Uganda, Milton Obote.
Somehow got involved in these NRM things of the bush. You disclose, because I hear you smuggled a young man called Ronald Mwenda Mutebi into the
yes.
so-called liberated zone?
Yes.
As who?
I had hated Obote so much.
Why? Because of 66?
Because of 66. Because he had said, Omuganda, Omurunji, Mufu, Nabichi. So, until about 2 years ago, when I wrote in my column, which has been going for nearly 30 years, as you know.
The column in Saturday.
The column One Man's Week.
Yes.
I wrote 2 years ago and said, I am finishing my hatred for UPC and Obote. I said, because what I've learned is that this kind of hatred actually poisons you. It's bad for you. And since I, if you like, Okwenenya, Kubaba Rokore, among whom I grew up, Gabenenya Nyo, confess. So I had confessed to all my readers around the world that I was giving up my hatred of Obote. And it really helped me. I became a better human being.
In the same interview, John Nagenda disclosed how he took the young Kabaka Ronald Mwenda Mutebi to different places.
Is the end tip. We are in the struggle first that brought
yes.
the movement. How do
yes.
you take Kabaka to Masaka?
I'll tell you, not just Masaka, by the way. Even to my farm, my tea estate, which was really getting towards the enemy. And then to Lemezi. To the place where the, what do they call it? Where the headquarters, it's not called headquarters, but the place, the front line. We even went to the front line. We were there. We stayed there for 2 or 3 days in small, about 2 days, in small little round huts.
John Nagenda, in an interview, talked about the human rights report that was destroyed.
Very gruesome to me.
Yes.
Every effort was taken not to have a report, which took us 9 years, including writing up. I've got the books there. There are, I think, 14 volumes of an average of about 800 pages. It's there in my house. It was sat upon by this government.
Why?
I know why.
Who is going to gain from
I know that? Why. Mm-hmm. Because the top leadership thought forgive and forget.
Some of his books included One Man's Week, An Unreserved Wisdom, published in 2019, Mokasa, among others.